Hello students, welcome back. So I hope you must be taking care of yourself and your family and you must be fit and fine. So today I am going to start a new chapter, chapter number 4 of geography, and chapter name is mineral and power resources. As I have already taught you about resources, so today we will discuss about the minerals and their power resources. So what do you understand by the minerals? A mineral is a naturally occurring substance that is solid and stable at room temperature. It also represents able by a chemical formula, usually a biogenic, and has an ordered atomic structure. It is really different from a rock, which can be an aggregate of minerals or non-minerals and does not have a specific chemical composition. The exact definition of a mineral is under debate, especially with respect to the requirement a valid species be a biogenic, and to a lesser extent with regards to it having an ordered atomic structure. As well, it is the study of mineral is called mineralogy. All right. So here I am discussing about the minerals. It is a natural occurring substance, that is naturally occurring substance, and it can be in a solid, stable at a room temperature. It is in a solid form. It is not in a liquid form. It is not in a gas form. It is in a solid form. And it actually represents by a chemical formula, okay, and it do have atomic structure, which is we can say it can be in many way. It can be in some like material, it can be in some rock. So that is what. Then there are different kinds of minerals, okay, stone, copper, iron, metal, silver. Okay, these are the different kinds of minerals. Now, what is metallic mineral? Metallic mineral contain metal in raw form. Metals are hard substances that conduct heat and electricity and have a characteristics luxure or shine. Iron, ore, bauxite, manganese and chromites contain iron. What is metallic iron? It is a raw form, okay, and it is hard substance which is actually which can be heated and that can be like luster or shine. So the most probably there are many examples like iron, manganese, okay, and bauxite, these all, and they all contains iron little bit, thoda bahut iron they have it. Now we will discuss about non-metallic minerals. Let's go. Extraction of minerals. What are extraction of minerals? Minerals can be extracted by mining, drilling and quarrying. Matlab, like they are extracted, okay, and they are different extracted in three different ways. They can mine, we can drill and we can quarry. Now here is the word mining. What is a mining? Extraction, I have told you. Now mining, it is the process of taking out minerals from rocks buried under the earth surface is called mining. Like we heard about gold mines, the coal mines, okay. So we dig it out and we find something. So that is what mining, okay. So that is the example, like the coal mines we have heard, now we define diamond in coal mines, okay. So that is what the mining, when we actually dig that surface that is under the earth surface, that is called the mining. Then here we are discussing types of mining, and that is open case mining and shaped mining. Open case mining minerals that lies as shallow depths are taken out by removing the surface layer is called as open case mining. And deep bores called shafts have to be made to reach minerals deposit that lie at great depths. This is called shaped mining. Distribution of minerals. Now mineral occur in different types of rock, and second, some are igneous rocks, some in metamorphic rocks, while other occur in sedimentary rocks. You must have heard in your junior classes like metamorphic rocks, sedimentary rocks, igneous rock. What are they? So they are the part of your minerals, okay. They are part of the distributions of minerals. So they are actually from where these rocks we get it from nature only, and they are the types of rocks. So we have studied in our junior classes that what are the types of rock. The types of rocks are igneous, metamorphic, sedimentary, and there only we get some minerals. Now Now here in this picture you can see continent wise distribution of minerals. Now what is Asia? India comes under Asia continent only, and in Asia we have China, and China is famous for iron, tin, antimony and tungsten. India is having iron, manganese, zinc and many other minerals. And Indonesia and Malaysia, this continent produces more than half of the world's tin. Then we are discussing about the Europe. Iron ore deposits Russia, Ukraine, Sweden and France. Mineral deposits of copper, lead, zinc, manganese and nickel are found in Eastern Europe and Russia. Then here we are discussing about North America. North America may, like, there is a Canadian shield that is fulfilled with iron ore, nickel, gold, uranium and copper. Then there's Appalachians region, there they have only one mineral and that is coal. Then there is Western Cordillera, that is with copper, lead, zinc, gold and silver. Then we are discussing about South America, other continent, and the Brazil. Brazil is having iron and ore and copper. Copper is like Chile and Peru. And then South America, totally we are talking about the whole continent, that is gold, silver, diamond, zinc, mica and chromium. And then the mineral oil, there are three, Venezuela, Chile, Peru and Colombia. Then the another continent, that is Africa. Africa is rich mineral, and you know the diamond is found only in the Africas. There are plenty of coal mines as well as gold also. So the diamond, gold and platinum, the richest mineral are in Africa. Then the Australia, largest producer in bauxite, leading producer in gold, diamond, iron ore, tin and nickel. And Antarctica, iron ore, silver, gold and oil are also present in commercial quantities. Are the uses of minerals? Number one, minerals are used in many industries. Number two, minerals which are used for gems are usually hard. Number three, copper is another metal used in everything from coins to pipes. Number four, silicon used in the computer industry is obtained from the quartz. And number five, aluminium obtained from its ore bauxite used in its automobile, airplanes, etc. Now the last topic is the conservation of minerals. Here the minerals are non-renewable resources. Okay, they are not the renewable resources. Second, it takes thousands of years for the formation and concentration of minerals. Third, the rate of formation is much smaller than the rate at which the humus consumes these minerals. Fourth, it is necessary to reduce wastage in the process of mining. And fifth, recycling of metal is another way in which the mineral resources can be conserved. Now the mineral and power resources chapter is over. I hope you guys have understood, and I have like explained with the continents, like which continent is having what kind of, contains which, what kind of minerals. Okay, I have taught you about the resources as well. So here I am winding up. I hope the topic is clear to you. Thank you so much.